yeah, not known for sure what his plans are, but he had said that, you know, being back here, a lot of emotion, a lot of fun. He got a visit from an old teammate, Neil Broughton. You know, they finished up with a big, exciting come-from-behind win at home the other night, Thursday night, and he got a big goal in that one. He said that was emotional, and then he comes here, and, you know, it's quite a ride.
Well, he's fortunate in the fact that he saw Stanley Cup playoffs, he saw the finals, and he even has a Stanley Cup ring. There's players that sometimes have to retire without that big silver cup in their resume. Well, Mike Modano did see Neil Broughton this morning. He did have other early mentors, though.
I think, you know, Brian Bellows is up there. I think Kurt Giles, the way he was, Stu Gavin, Mike Gartner, Larry Murphy, guys that had, you know, tremendous careers, Basil, Shane Cherla, guys who, you know, they were hard on me, but I think in a good way. It toughened me up. It kind of made me humble and appreciate what I have and what I've accomplished and where I'm at right now.
You got to give the Dallas Stars credit because they wanted to finish on a good note as well. And these guys, both teams, forced it to the very end.
They're going to want to stay with us here as the Wild will stay on the ice for a few minutes. The Dallas Stars congratulating themselves on a season-ending victory. A 4-3 Dallas win in the shootout. Mike Modano, did he just finish his last National Hockey League game? Nobody knows for sure.
Star and fans, player of the game, in honor of 20 distinguished seasons that started right here in the state of hockey in 1989, Mike Modano.
I gotta tell you, Mike, growing up here watching the North Stars all my life, I got a little chill down the spine when you came out of that tunnel in that North Star sweater.
What does it say about an organization, though, that will do something like this? And that's why the Wild and their fans are the best, because they will look beyond one side or the other. They will say, we appreciate hockey and we appreciate hockey players like Mike Modano.
Does this look like a guy that's playing next year?
It doesn't, does it? It doesn't, but you know, funnier things happen just because, you know, things will happen this summer that maybe put it beyond his control to say, hey, maybe one more year. There's been plenty of players, you know, that have thought about that at the last second. And, you know, I know that fans would love to see him play more, but maybe he has decided to move on and take on some other challenges. And, you know, there's been rumors that he might become an owner someday. So you never know what direction Mike Modano will go.
Well, Kevin, Darby, pretty emotional moment for Mike Modano and for a lot of longtime Minnesota hockey fans here this evening.
Yeah, what a special night. And like you mentioned, Dan, growing up here in Minnesota, watching Mike Modano make his debut as a baby-faced youngster back in 1989, getting his feet wet in the playoffs, and then seeing him basically take a franchise in the Minnesota North Stars that was going nowhere fast in the late 80s, the brilliant run to the Stanley Cup in 1991, falling in six games to the Pittsburgh Penguins. But what I'll never forget about Mike Modano is when he got that puck, it was electricity. Jersey flapping up and down that ice, and tonight, what a tribute.
Pretty impressive, and what an incredible career. Andrew Burnett was touching on that in his interview in the pregame about just how electric he was to play against, to watch, how his jersey would fly, how he could shoot. And we saw his early years in Minnesota. I mean, whether you're a high school kid or an adult or just a fan in general, he made the game fun to watch. And there weren't too many, in my opinion, better ever to play the game than Mike Modano. Fitting if this is his last game, that it is Minnesota where he started. But started here early. You saw his talent, but matured, became a very well-rounded player in Dallas, won a cup. And a terrific career, you know, 1,400 games, seven All-Stars, on and on and on and on. But a great, great player. He's been so great for so long. And you think about his career, every game he plays, he's got top checkers on him, you know, throughout his career. But you're able to get through that. You're able to get better. You're able to emerge as a player to grow and continue to help make your team better. And ultimately, that's what he did. He made his team a great team that won a cup with Dallas. All his teammates love him. It's one of the great tributes to him. He's always been liked by his teammates. But what he's done, not only for the NHL, but we talked about it in the pregame as well, USA Hockey. Three Olympics, you know, a lot of young players now have emerged. The young Zach Parise's, they grew up watching him as a U.S. Olympian, and being inspired to want to be great like him. But his career, amazing, and a pleasure to watch him every night.
We've been watching him for 20 years, and why not watch him for what could be one last game? And Mike Modano's coming off of a very good hockey game back in Dallas, and where he had a goal and assist and a shootout winner. And even though he didn't get a lot of points here tonight, he certainly showed why he could be one of the better players, just being involved in the play and being the kind of player that you look for in key situations. Watch this on the backhand. Kind of rolls off his stick, had the net to look at, but Mike Modano has seen plenty of looks like that and put him home. Of course, he helps set up plays too. I mean, Modano, his vision on the ice is what made him such a good hockey player right there on the back door. Neil just kind of loses a little bit, but certainly a good effort there.
I didn't know what to expect, obviously, going in tonight, and the reception was phenomenal. You know, still tons of big North Star jerseys out there and fans that still you know, miss us, and in some ways we still miss them. And but it was a great game nonetheless, but you know, times a little emotional.
Mike, was very emotional for you. Did I see a few tears in that standing ovation or not?
A little bit. The longer it dragged on, the tougher it was to kind of get through that. But I think I used them up all the other night in Dallas. And but yeah, it was touching. You know, it's really hard to put it in words how much you appreciate the, you know, the fans in the city here at such a young age coming in and, you know, kind of taking me in and having some great experiences and some great friendships and, you know, some great times the 5 years I was here. So, and still see some faces I saw at Met in the stands. So it's very nice.
During warmups, you seemed to be looking around and trying to spot some people. Were you able to find them?
Yeah, I finally found, you know, where my wife and was sitting, and a friend of mine from Dallas who flew up too. So I just wanted to find out where they were situated. If there were some tough moments I needed to get through, but, yeah, that was it. I kept the group small coming up here.
Mike, have you made up your mind? Is this it?
You know, I was really, you know, kind of really struggled with that answer, and I really don't know. I don't know what happens over the summer. I know our situation with Tom Hicks is certainly up in the air, and, you know, what holds for you know, Marty Turco and Yuri Lehtinen. A lot of personnel things are happening that you know, need to get worked out, and certainly a contract would need to get worked out and that thing. But I think those things would be, a contract would be easy. But I guess what I feel in July and August, I think it's really tough to make a decision right now. You're kind of exhausted and tired, and the itch that ended July and August to kind of figure out what you want to do. But there's a lot that goes into it, a lot of thinking on things I'm going to do.
Well, obviously an emotional night for Mike Modano, and in an era, Darby, where players jump ship and change teams on a regular basis, it really does say something. He's been with this franchise now for 20 years, and if he does end up having his last game being played right here in Minnesota where it started, I think it'd be perfect.
And if he wants to jump ship and come play for the Wild, why not, huh? Incredible career, Hall of Fame. I mean, that's how I see Mike Modano, a Hall of Fame player, whatever he does, but why not Brett Favre at quarterback and Mike Modano at center ice for the Wild?
Not a bad way to do it. And boy, you can tell, though, and you know from being a player that's connected with the fans you've played for, when you play in the NHL, when you have the success like a guy like Mike Modano's had, it's very difficult to walk away.
Well, it is, and I think what he said, you want to decompress. There's a lot of emotions that go involved with it. Everybody's anticipating that it is the end of his career, but I think he needs to personally sit down and make that decision with his family, with his close friends, and do it when he's rested. Do it when the emotions are set aside. And, you know, once you're done, most of the times you're done, and that's it. And for him to have the career he had, most people don't really get to make the choice that the game makes it for him. You're out. But he's a different guy. He's been in a different category, and he's earned that right to make it when he's comfortable.
Yeah, 20 years in the league, 3 times an Olympian, 7 times an NHL All-Star, and most importantly, Darby, he won a Stanley Cup. And I think it might be a little easier for Mike Modano that he has that cup, that he's not wondering, well, if I can come back one more time or change teams, I can make that cup run. That's not in the back of his mind. He's got that in his holster.
Yeah, and you know, when I watch him skate, he still skates great. I mean, that's the thing. You you wanted to see him keep playing because he's been so great for the game. He's been fun to watch. And hockey needs more people like Mike Modano. He's made it fun. He's made it electrifying. People love him. They can identify him with him. And they need more people like him. They need more players like him. But it is his call, and he is a first-class guy, too. And that is the truth. And everybody says that about him, and it's the truth. He's first class.